Hello everybody, I'm your friendly neighborhood Let's Player SpiderMwa, and welcome you to Let's Play Bowling, or PPA Bowling, if you want to call it that, on the Intellivision. It's been ages since I've done any kind of Intellivision game, and I decided, I'll do one now, because I haven't thought of any adventure game to play right now, because I finished Toonstruck last week. And, I haven't really decided on what game I will play next. There's so many adventure games to choose from. So I decided, let's play something silly for a while. Well, not really silly. This is a bowling game, and it's pretty well done on the Intellivision, I have to say. So we're gonna go for bowling, gonna be the only one. And slickness is just gonna be 2, because You can choose up to 10 in slickness, which means it will be a very, very slippery game area. And I don't really... Aisle. Yeah, that's what it's called, and a bowling aisle. So the aisle would have been a very slick. But if I put it down to 1, it's not going to be very slick. So ball weight, I'm going to go with 10 pounds. Bowler hand is going to be right, because I am right-handed. There we go. The beautiful... bong sound that nearly raped my ear. Thank you. Should have checked all the volume levels. So let's pick that up and move our bowler into position. That's about right. You use the sight buttons to move your bowler around, and then use the bottom right to actually use the aim. You can see the white ball on the aisle there. Probably not even see it because it's white against yellow. But it's there. And once you put your aim into place, then you can use the disc to give it a little curve if you want to. Let's aim for the middle right there, and a slight curve upwards. Come on, come on, come on, come on. That looks like a strike. Come on. Yes! And I always get that lovely Intellivision audience cheering once you make a strike. So the game can be easy, it depends on how you play it. Like, I don't have much slickness in the game, so it's gonna be very easy to get strikes. Well, I say that now, but watch me fail on the next one. Hoop-dia! A slight curve again. Just to give it that little curve so it can go. Yeah, see? Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes, 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 yes! No! It came down too early.
It's very easy to get some strikes on this one.
See what happens if you get too cocky? Yeah, just like Han Solo says, don't get cocky. This happens. So, let's see, that's all the way to the top. Okay, and then... a little aim, and don't even give it a curve. Don't even give it a curve. Just let it go straight. I should have given it a little curve. Damn it. Well, didn't get any points for that. So, it's a basic bowling game. It's nothing spectacular to speak of. But pretty much what I wanted to say while I play this is just that... yeah, I haven't really thought of any kind of what adventure game I'm gonna start now. And really? I did that bad? Jeez. Gave it the wrong kind of curve. So I haven't really thought of any kind of adventure game I'm gonna play next. So it's gonna be... I'm gonna leave it until next year. Which is gonna be soon anyway, because it's New Year's Eve in a few days. Like, in 2 days, it's gonna be New Year's Eve and New Year's Day, so next Monday I'm gonna start a new adventure game, but I still haven't planned on which one. So many to choose from, and they're gonna be longer games now, because I've pretty much done all the ones that are in 20 parts or so, so these are gonna be a lot longer. Just like my Fallout series, it's gonna be a long, long game. Just still have to decide on what game I'm gonna play. That might be a strike. Nope. It's a heavy split. I hate splits like that. I really do, because I'm bad at covering them. Let's see if I can actually do this, and there, and a little curve. Come on, turn to the left. Come on. Oh, man. Just missed by a pixel. Damn it.
Yeah, this game is very easy. It's easy to get strikes on this.
Oh, man. Let's play this curse. Never boast yourself. That is a sure way to start failing at games. Another split. Perfect. That's what I needed. Another split. I know some of the sounds in the game are very loud, but hey, that's Intellivision for you. It's always loud. So hopefully it doesn't rape your ears as well as mine. And I put myself in a way wrong position. Way wrong position. And that's the wrong curve. I put it the wrong way. Everything's going wrong. Ha ha.
Can't even get a goddamn spare anymore.
Oh well. That's the name of the game in bowling. I was never good at bowling in real life either. Not that good, at least, I'm just say. Yay! Strike! Woo! When you get a strike, you gotta, you know, have to celebrate it a little bit. But this is gonna be a short video, just me announcing how I'm gonna do. I do have a lot of choices, and one of the choices is something that I don't really don't want to do, because I've been telling people many times that it's a game that I do not want to play at all. But many of you have actually requested me to do it. Because I don't know why. I don't know why you want to see me play that game. And that game is Escape from Monkey Island, the fourth installation in the Monkey Island series. And I hate that game. I've played it a little bit by myself. Well, not even a little bit, quite a lot. But it doesn't make me laugh. It's not like the other Monkey Island games at all. It's the controls in it. Well, the controls are not bad because it's done in the Grim Fandango era, so it's kind of similar, so it's easy to use. But the jokes, it's the jokes, the writing. Guybrush is a freaking asshole. Well, not really an asshole, but he's not the same Guybrush that we all know. He's written really badly. And some of the jokes just don't work for me, and there's lots of puzzles that are just ridiculously difficult to do. It just fails in so many levels as an adventure game and as a Monkey Island game, to be more precise. Because what do you like about Monkey Island the most? The characters, right? Yeah. It's the characters that you like the most, especially our protagonist, that being Guybrush Threepwood. But he's written so badly that I hate him in that game. I really, really hate him. And I'm getting strikes all over the place, apparently. Gotta be more angry, apparently, to get more strikes. That is the marking that is the last throw in the game. Usually when you get that whistle, it means that you are at the 10th frame. So these are your final shots to get yourself a triple strike. If you want to. Your extra throws. So let's go for it. Go for it. And curve. That didn't do well. Oh, yes! There's the whistle again. It's an extra throw. So yeah, Escape from Monkey Island. A possibility, but not a probability. Because I really don't like it. Other choices that I have is starting Gabriel Knight series, because I really, really love those games. But if I do Gabriel Knight, I'm not sure if I'm gonna do the original or the new version that I got. I got it as a gift from a friend, the 20th anniversary version, which has newer graphics, it's pretty much the same story, and all the puzzles are still the same, just new graphics, new voice acting. So it's a lot different in those, but otherwise it's the same game. So I'm not sure which one I will do if I start the Gabriel Knight series. I probably might go with the new version, the 20th anniversary, maybe. I'm not sure. And other adventure games? Well, not. I don't really know. I might migrate from pure adventure games into RPGs, because I love RPG games. Like, there's Baldur's Gate, Planescape Torment, there are lots of first-person shooters that I would like to do, but I'm not sure of it. I might even go to playing PlayStation 1 games that I like there's Resident Evil, Final Fantasy 7 or 9, which one? Not gonna touch 8, because 8 is just stupid. It's not a bad game. I always liked playing Final Fantasy 8. It had its own charm, but the story in it is something that everybody discusses about a lot, because it's really, really dumb. So yeah, there's a few choices that I can go to, but I really haven't decided yet what to go to, so we'll see next Monday what I have decided. Really? The middle one? So that's just how it's gonna end, huh? 160 points! Not bad. Not bad, really. I did badly, but it's not bad. It's pretty okay, I'd say, for an amateur of my standards. So yeah, that was bowling on the Intellivision. And those are my thoughts about what I'm going to do next Monday, so I'm going to leave it at that. You can give me suggestions of all the names that I've already dropped, or you can give me suggestions on adventure games that I should or could try. It just depends on myself, really, on what I'm in the mood for. I really haven't decided yet, so next Monday, next year, it's going to be a new year. New kind of style. Well, not really a new style. It's still gonna be me. I'm not gonna change anything. I'm just gonna progress into a further era in adventure games. As in, you know, I've been in the 90s and 80s, old school adventure games. I might, you know, progress to a little further in timelines. Not be so nostalgic anymore. But, of course, I'm gonna be nostalgic in so many other ways. With the Amiga, Commodore 64, Intellivision, here. Lots of old games still gonna be played. But I might move on from adventure games to something else. First-person shooters, platforming. You never know. I can be full of surprises, you know. But enough about me rambling. That was bowling. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the video. And I hope you all have a good evening, good afternoon, and a good morning. And I will see you all next time. Take care, people. Bye.